didn't know whether I was allowed in yet.
Come in.
Thank you. Cheers. If that's good.
Yeah,
that's
what you like. Tea or coffee?
Cup of tea, two sugars is nice. As long as Mr. Sullivan's okay with that. Oh, okay.
Oh, I know. I'll go straight through.
Am I going straight through?
I'll bring the tea in.
I
think there's a man I've been wanting to see for a long time.
There you are.
Nice to meet you.
Have a sit there. You've got a tough job, haven't you?
No, I think you've got a tougher one.
Well, no, do you work freelance or do you work full time?
Well, I'll get to that. It's sort of freelance. It's our thing.
That's hard.
It's our publication.
Very hard. Very hard.
You're
on the publication?
Yeah.
Well, that's all right then. And you break it even?
Sort of.
Well, have you got a copy?
No.
And how many editions have you had?
Three.
Very hard. And how does anybody know about it to buy it then?
Well, what we've been may I call you David or
Yeah, David, yeah.
What I've been trying to do is we're trying to get a deal with WH Smiths.
So you're not in Smiths at the moment?
No.
Not retail?
We've got a deal with Time Out Distribution in London. So they do something for us, but they only take about 6,000. We have to flog the rest. It's sort of quite hard.
And how do you sell them?
I put them in the boot of my car and go and blag people.
But most people sell magazines on sale and return.
Yeah, yeah. Well, we do get returns, but as I said on the little facts, I mean, I was. Can I put this here?
Yeah, do whatever you like.
That's video in you, that is.
Is it really?
Yeah, because I want to remember this for when you've forgotten about me. I want to remember you.
Very efficient. What's your name?
My name's John.
Right. Where do you live, John?
I live in a lovely town called Wellingborough in Northamptonshire. And it's a pigsty of a place.
Oh, were you born there?
No, I was born in a nice town called a village called Turvey, which was a nice place.
Yeah.
But I didn't know.
Have you tried other distributors?
Well, you're going to think I'm a bit silly here, but I don't know many distributors.
And how many are you printing the magazine?
15,000.
And how many do you think you're selling?
We are selling 7,000, and that's why. When you asked me about the ABC things and whatnot, now I thought to myself.
You don't want an ABC when you're selling 7,000.
Well, something like that. I thought to myself, you could have someone in here that is shifting 200,000 magazines. I mean, you could have Mr. Dennis down here, couldn't you?
Yeah.
You could have Felix down here with his Maxim or whatever he's got going now.
Yeah.
He doesn't like me very much.
Why doesn't he like you?
Well, I tried to speak to him the other day, but
he's not a bad guy normally.
I think he's great, but I don't think he practices what he preaches. And I think one of the things he preached, which stuck in my mind, David, was do it first, apologise for it later. And I think that was one thing that he came out with. So I ended up round his house the other Sunday. Just missed the party that you probably were at.
No, I never got invited.
Well, you never got invited to it.
I only met him, he came to our birthday party, funny enough, the sport birthday party. He's actually walking by and he came in. But he lives up in the Cotswolds or something.
He lives in Dorsington.
What did you call his house? Well, you wouldn't appreciate that.
Well, I was polite.
Yeah, but people don't know that, do they, on the weekend?
I don't know whether you've ever been to his place. But perhaps we don't talk about him too much. We'll
but
talk about
you've got
you
go quick because you know you've got half an hour and that's it.
All right.
What you got to do is get a distributor to America.
Well, thank you very much. Cheers. I didn't come here for that, but thanks anyway.
Quick.
Well, I'm going to ask you a couple of questions, if I may.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to, in the last 5 minutes, I'm going to show you something.
Yeah.
I ain't going to frighten you or anything, but I'm going to show you something which I've got here.
Yeah.
Okay. Because you are a multi-millionaire and I'm not.
Yeah.
Right. So, sorry about some of these, but we'll just see how we go, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, background. Council estate or manor house?
Council estate.
Okay, brothers and sisters?
One brother.
Okay, how's...
Are you recording this? It's all on the video, is it?
It's all in that microphone pen there.
Yeah, okay.
Does he do well, your brother?
Works for me.
So he's doing all right then?
Doing all right.
Do you believe in the nepotism thing then?
What's nepotism?
It's where your children, your brothers and sisters and anyone else that's related to you works for you and they get a step up the ladder before people that have worked for you for 20 years do.
hard to say really.
I'm blood thicker than water.
Yeah, but I think you've also got to, if you just promote on nepotism rather than ability, the company will go bust. You with me? You could give somebody an edge, but for the survival of a company, it's important the best people in that company run that company. Sometimes I've got to tell you, you do promote on seniority and
attract
loyalty, and they're not always the right people for the job. So I'm actually very loyal to old staff, and I've had people work for me for 40 odd years. Really, they should be retired now, you know.
But they like working for you.
Yeah, and they don't want to retire.
Well, so you don't want to retire either, do you? So
I'm gonna retire. I'm getting rid of some. I'm getting rid of the sport shortly. I'm getting rid of all my internet businesses.
What are you going to keep?
My sex shops, my property, and do something new.
When are you getting rid of the sport?
Maybe in 4 to 6 weeks.
Oh, cool. Okay. Didn't want you to do that.
No, well,
I wanted you to keep that one.
Well, we like the sport, but it's the price of, I want to, at the moment I work 12 hours a day. I work 7 days a week. I don't work 12 hours at the weekend, but I do work the weekend. If I have a holiday, I spend 3 hours on the internet replying to emails.
I was watching you on telly typing into that computer. Yeah. You must get rid of keyboards once a month for the way
quickest,
you type.
I'm the quickest one finger type.
Well, you're like this, aren't you?
Yeah.
You must replace those every year.
No, they last, funny enough. But no, I've done it for 37 years, and I want to like my work though. If you read Felix's book about
I bought it the other day.
Yeah, it's a nice, very nice book, and it's got some very good stuff in it. And he's had the ability to find good young people who are better at doing it than he is. So it releases his time. I've struggled all my life to find good people.
Have you?
Yeah.
Why?
Because most of the good people run their own businesses.
So it's not a question of money then? It's not a question you just throw money at it to get the best people?
No, sometimes you can spend a pile of money and get someone that's no good. But what's the next question?
Yeah, right, council house then, yeah?
Yeah.
But what's your first car?
Ford Capri.
Did it all work properly?
Yeah, because I've always had an ability to make money. So at 18 I had quite a few grand in the bank, which was an awful lot of money 40 years ago.
How did you get that money?
Selling football programs, mail order.
Of course you did, yeah, of course you did.
So I had a brand new Capri. I mean, my brother had a car that we funded, actually, saying that before that, because he could drive before I, because he was 2 years old, we bought a Hillman Husky van to transport the football programs, and that we used to have to hammer the handbrake in with jam a nail in. That was 40 quid, and that didn't work properly. But then when I got a car, I got a Ford Capri, a brand new one, and he worked at Ford at the time, so we got like 20% discount.
What year? What are you talking? L? What are you talking? 73? 70? 69G?
You're talking. '77.
What, SV then? Something around there? Yeah, probably that's irrelevant.
Could have been FEV 242H, but it could have been a later one.
H. IJK, HIJK, oh, that's about 71, isn't it, H?
No, I think you're wrong.
Am I?
I definitely had an FEV 242H, and that could have been my first car.
Alright, well, I'm not arguing with you.
Yeah,
it's
but
your
no,
car.
I mean, it could, if you said it was 80 something, I could have been giving you the number of a later car, you
yeah.
with me? But the. But I think it was that FEV 242H.
Okay, fair enough. What's your best car? Do you like cars?
Yeah. No, I'm not. I mean, I've got a Rolls Royce Phantom.
Is that one of them new things?
Yeah, which is a fantastic car. And
do you sit in the back of it or do you drive it?
Both. You know, it's probably the best car I've ever been in. I'm not somebody who wants to drive a high performance car, but breaks down. A lot of Ferraris, I know people have Ferraris that break down. So that's the best car I've ever had.
Okay. Bearing in mind how much time we've got.
Yeah.
You got a criminal record?
Yep.
What for?
For sending indecent literature to the post.
That makes sense. Do you discriminate against people with criminal records?
Depends,
I mean, obviously child molesters.
Depends what they are.
Would you agree with? Someone said to me once, "I'll make £1 million or I'll end up in prison." Would you agree with that? I know you don't know me.
That was said to me as well.
That was said to you as well?
Yeah, and I did both.
Right.
You know.
So we do have something in common then.
Yeah. What did you get sent to prison for?
I didn't go to prison, but I nearly went, and I nearly made £1 million.
Yeah.
Well, I did both.
Two by the time my economics festival, I did it by the time I was 30. And I made the money while I was 25, and I went to prison at 33, but I won an appeal and I got out after 10 weeks.
Did you have millions of pounds in the bank by then, though?
Yes.
So that helps?
It does help.
Best people.
Yeah. No, best people still. The best people didn't perform for me, the lesser people performed.
Did you make any friends in prison? Or weren't there to.
I made one or two. I made one guy who's a master criminal, unfortunately, is a recidivist.
Now, I don't know what that means.
Recidivist means they commit crimes.
Right.
The guy got enormous buzz, and he's back, unfortunately, back inside, I think, for the rest of his life.
I wish we had more time, you know.
I really haven't got it.
I could give you my time.
Yeah. No, but
I only have £5.
A lot of people rely on me for living.
All right. First £1 million then. You must have noticed it. You'd have been aiming for it, I'd have thought.
Yeah, probably when I was 24, 25.
And that was... What made you that?
Things like sex education books, things like that.
So you're publishing them yourself as well?
Yeah, I was buying the rights and publishing them, yeah.
Right. What's it like when you see a bit of paper with six noughts on it?
Wonderful.
Yeah.
You feel you've got secure. I mean, and don't forget, 34 years ago, it's a lot more than it is now.
Yeah.
It was a very, very large amount of money.
I think you're an incredible person. I don't know if you know that.
Well, not all. When I look at... See, I've picked a business that's actually quite a small business. The sex industry, contrary to what people think, is small. If you put it next to mobile phones or sports shops selling football things, the huge money has been made in those businesses. And whilst I was one of the top players in my own industry, if not the top player with the papers, the films, I've done every part of the business, and it has netted me a very large sum of money, if you put me next to the mobile phone giants, Richard Branson's of this world, or even the guys bought Newcastle, who sold out his sports chain shop for 2,000 million quid. I'm a pauper. So, you know.
Yeah, I'm having trouble. I'm feeling sorry for you here.
Yeah. No. I'm just making the statement of fact. Because I chose a certain business, or by chance ended up in that business, I believe. You know, had I spotted something better, like the mobile phone business,
you'd have done that.
Because there's a million people made big sums of money out of the mobile phone business who got in early.
Well, Mr. Caldwell would be one
of them. Yeah, but there's lesser people. He's actually quite a talented man, and he would have probably done well whatever he did. But there's other people, like you think Mark Goldberg, who bought Crystal Palace, made tens of millions. There's all sorts of people made money out who are not great geniuses.
Okay.
So, anyway.
You're going to have to forgive me because I'm going to ask you because I want to get to the point.
The point's at the end. Yeah.
You got a woman?
I've got a permanent girlfriend, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Did you get into porn because you like naked pictures of birds? I mean, everyone does.
Yeah.
But, I mean...
I didn't get into porn. I got into girly magazines, yeah, partly. Because I was at university in a predominantly all-male university. And I went to a nurse's home for a party, and I thought to myself, whatever job you do, you've got to get a job where the ratio of women to men is in your favour. Because I went from being, I was in the university where there was like, my particular thing I was doing economics, there was like 15 men to every girl.
Right.
So you never got to go out with a girl unless you would look like a movie star, or you had a rich dad.
So you break down the...
But if the night I went to the nurse's home, I felt like a movie star because there was all these girls, I was fighting them off.
Yeah.
So I thought, well, I had to get something. But I actually went, I went into the porn business or the sex business or the girly business, call it what you like, because I just read an article in the News of the World.
I heard you say that.
Yeah, and that is the truth. But the knowing the fringe benefit, you'd meet lots of models. And I would always say to somebody, if you're doing nothing with your life, you should either be a photographer, and you want to meet girls, be a photographer or open a model agency, model management. Because the average photographer goes out with far more attractive girls than he'd ever meet if he was a bus driver. You with me?
Do you know what then? if I want to do something in my life and I want to meet people like you, I have a magazine then, don't I?
Maybe you have a magazine, maybe you write a book. People, if people like to speak to people who are writing books.
Well, I'm really yeah. pleased to see
What's
you, because I'm the, I remember
point?
Saying... right, how big are your kahunas then? You got big balls.
Big, what, in business?
Yeah.
As you get older, less. When you start off with nothing, you have to take a chance. But to be honest, as I get older, I can't be bothered.
Okay. What about team players? Any good? Probably good.
What?
Well, couldn't imagine you being a team player.
Well, no, in terms of what, though?
Well, Mr. Dennis hit the nail on the head with it. I think he's right. Team playing is for losers that will never make any money other than working for someone else.
I don't know what he's for. I mean, I think you've got to listen to other people's opinions who you work with. So whether that makes you a team player or not a team player, I don't know.
Have you got good people working for you?
Got some quite good people.
Quite good people?
Yeah.
Well, on 100 grand a year, quite good people.
Yeah.
You could get better people for less than that. I could introduce them to you.
I'm sure, but something you have to have loyalty to your staff.
You do?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's nice that you say that, but...
You know.
Yeah, alright then. Okay, are you still interested in making money? Do you care anymore?
The... Yes and no, I would say. I think you get to the point, you know, it's more important you do things you want to do. Or, if something is absolutely so good at making money, you can't turn it down.
So... You're stepping out of Sunday Sport, and I'm not prying. I'm just interested. Why?
Because
is that enough now?
I want to take my life in. And also, I've had a change of staff up there, and I don't like dealing with the new staff as much as the old staff.
So you don't like your own people working for you?
No.
No. I'll have a job with you.
No.
You'd
upset people. I can see your personality. You're such a strong personality.
Yeah, but you know, you're putting me in this position. I'd like to sit and have a lovely cup of tea with you and spend time.
A little bit, yeah.
But yeah, because you're giving me a deadline, and I've got to get my thing out as quick as. I mean, I'll never meet you again.
Well, you can always you can email me or fax me.
Oh God, what, along with 100,000 other sodding people that
I'll
do it?
I promise you, I do reply to people. I'm the most accessible person.
You're a nice man. I appreciate that, because I've met some not nice people with less money than you.
Yeah.
And they're not very nice. I'm not going to ask you that question. So if I'm going to get to a point in a minute, and then we're going to.
What did you nearly get banged up for?
ABH. Some bloke down the pub decided to touch my girlfriend's breast, so I hit him.
You know what you should do?
Well, I waited to go into the toilet. I mean, I don't agree with that behaviour, but I don't agree with someone staring at my girlfriend all night and then...
What he's done is wrong, but people stare.
He tried to grab him.
Yeah, but you can't just bash someone
like that. Well, I did give him a warning.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not like that.
But what you should have done was, twisted his arm or something. Would you have inflicted the pain?
In hindsight, David, I would have... And I don't want you to get the wrong idea. In hindsight, he called the police. He knew why he got hit. I only hit him twice. I wasn't there to try and kill the man. He needed to be taught a lesson, just like I have to be taught lessons with people, you know. So I gave him a couple of slaps, and he called the police, and made it a lot worse than what it was. And but from a moral point of view, he stepped over the line. He knew he was wrong, and. I'm sorry, I mean, you've come from areas, I mean, we all know what...
There ain't any profit, you see, what
well,
you
no
did...
Profit in that. Yeah, it cost me 700
about,
quid.
Well, you see, you've got two solutions to that, if you think about it, and believe me, we've all got a breaking point in it, but the reality is, you can give him a smack, and... really hurt him badly, well then you get nicked.
Yeah.
Or the converse is, you might find he's a bit bigger and harder than you think he is, and you could get smacked.
Well, there is that.
There was no gain either way.
I didn't go into that situation with trying to hurt the man.
No.
I always try and be logical with things.
You've got to give a little lesson.
But that's me being honest with you.
Yeah.
Now, if I said that to someone else, I probably wouldn't even get in their doorway.
Yeah.
But we live in the real world, you know. I want to show you this. I didn't know whether you're going to want to... tick the boxes. You meant to do it in like 2 minutes, but I had an idea of putting a book together. with the richest people in the country.
Decide how much you agree or disagree with, put a tick in one of the boxes there, whether or not I get to be.
It's difficult for you because you're at the top.
Depends on my ability.
You don't have to do it. I was planning on publishing something if I could get rich people to do it.
To a great extent, my life is controlled by external happenings.
I wanted to see how close you are to me, because I know what my answers were.
I feel like what happens in my world is mostly driven by powerful people. Whether or not I'll get in a tight tie, it depends mostly on how good a driver I am. When I make plans, I'm also make them more. Often there's no chance of protecting my personal interests from bad luck happenings.
Thanks for doing that. Stop whenever you want.
When I get what I want, it's usually because I'm lucky. When you work for someone else,
don't answer it then if it's